Everyone, Wanderbot here, and welcome to Synthetik 2 Early Access. So I played the demo for this a couple months ago, really, really loved it, and now it's out. It's a roguelite, actually, isometric shooter. Isometric, it's like kind of a mix between top-down and isometric. I've seen a lot of people go one direction or another with that sort of thing, but... ooh. Okay, those are my shields. My shields were cooked. Missed it. I don't know what you are. Spooky, that's what you are. Okay. I explode on anything kind of in my general vicinity, which is neat. But only when I'm doing my dodge. Whew. I'm digging this heavy pistol. The damage on it is incredible, but at the same time, oof. There's a one, there's a two. Nope. Big miss. Failed. Okay. I don't know what these guys use weapon-wise. I don't know if I've taken damage yet. I'm gonna assume I might have. I love that dash. At the same time, it's bright. Where am I going? Oh, that turns off the... oh! Turns off the UI, but it gives me a map. There we go. There we go. Why is boot my weapon? Oh, does the radar just tell me where boxes and stuff are? Alright, cool. I was really hoping I'd hit that barrel. I'm not actually sure if... hitting the barrel does anything. Or the barrel of the canister. You know, I was kind of hoping I could blow it up in their face. I know there's explosive barrels and the like. I guess I just don't have access to them. There we go. Running and gunning on this game. Good for certain characters, not this guy. Especially not with his current loadout. Alright, I think we're good. I don't know what kind of secrets I should be keeping an eye out for. I know you can find them on the map, here and there. I'm not sure. That's what I get for not looking. Okay, oh. Heavy pistol leveled up. There we go. And yes, there are headshots in this game. I think it's kind of obvious, based on how much damage I do if I'm accurate. But if it's not, it is 100% a thing. As are backstabs. I don't think I actually processed that I could backstab with a gun. But at the same time, I am not terribly surprised that it's a thing. If there was a game to pull that sort of stuff off, it would be this one. There we go. So much of the strategy, as far as I'm concerned... oh, yeah, they really did change the UI with this one. Much of the strategy, as far as I'm concerned, as far as I know... is find safe spots. There we go. Find safe spots to specifically stop and shoot. You almost immediately get your accuracy back. You only are wildly inaccurate out of combat. Or not out of combat. You're only wildly inaccurate when you're moving. Okay, don't take too much damage. Squandered it, but it's fine. I'm gonna keep on keeping on and keep on taking it slow. Nice and slow. Shock lightning. Shotgun loaded with electric shells, high damage output, low range, and ammo reserves. Oh! Alright, I'll take it. The damage on that is a thing. Alright. It's going to take a little while to reload this. And boy hootie. Nope. Yep. It worked. Grab that. We've got plenty of ammo. Kind of. Okay, what else do we have? Got one more bullet. But man, you want to delete somebody, you use this thing. pop that. There we go. Can I actually get more ammo on this? Maybe I can, maybe I can't. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, passively gives ammo efficiency. Imbues weapons with explosive. Shots explode for extra damage. I wonder if that's only while I'm inside the region for it. I had a guess that'd be the case. There we go. But man, one shot, one judicious kill. It is satisfying. Okay, where am I going? Where is the exit? Looks like this looks like a no. I want to go back in here. It's probably up the back side of this. Nope, shooting range. Maybe it's this door. This door looks imposing. It looks imposing, but also incorrect. Dang. I mean, it's generally where I want to go. What about this? Aha. Bye. Oh, bring the boom. Okay, bad time to be low on juice. There we go. And we are jammed, and we're good. There we go. I don't have a commentary to properly encapsulate the ridiculousness of this. Oh, that's a currency now. That used to be like an upgrade. Do we pop this? I'm not actually sure if that even does any good for me. Well, it's okay. Let's see, how are we doing? We're doing great. We got something back here. Woo! There we go. I'm just gonna give that the boot. Oof. Absolutely no mercy to my shield levels. I wonder if kicking things actually just wrecks it. Frontal kick with power boots. Deals armor ignoring ion damage. Damage against turrets is doubled. No, I must have just gotten hit, or maybe the enemy exploded. I'm not sure. Okay, well, this door doesn't open anymore, but we do have a weapon crate. Okay. So now we have a heavy assault rifle on top of everything else. I think you can carry up to 3 weapons, one sidearm, 2 main guns. But I'm not entirely sure. Let's switch to the pistol here. See if I can replace it. Starter weapon cannot be dropped. Well, RPG death stick. No. There we go. Okay, wrong gun. There we go. This was the gun that I meant to have. It's fine. We only took a little bit of damage. Gain armor. And get everything back. Biggest issue is just going to be reload. Oh, it was a trapped chest. Of course. Okay, shock net. Shots can fire a shock net, immobilizes enemies. Oh, so that's just a passive. There we go. Just absolutely destroy them. Okay, anything else? Everything seems to be up ahead. Can I go through here? Yes. Well, this went poorly. There we go. Is this the assault rifle? Yes. Good time to back off. So that's the shock net. Seems like these guys are pretty panicked. I feel like this is immediately a lot easier than the last one. And the environment actually makes sense as a location. Like, playing Synthetic 1, it more or less just felt like I was wandering the abyss. This one feels a lot better. Guardian. Losing shield summons a guardian, can draw fire with its durability, comes with an armor aura. Neat. I wonder how limited I am with a number of these things. I like that shotgun, but I like this gun. It was one of those games that you generally will fall in love with most weapons and fall out of love with, like, maybe a handful of them. You know, it's like 90% of guns are great. 10% of guns are just like absolute garbage. You want nothing to do with them. Which honestly is a really good place to be. I can't think of a whole lot of games like that other than maybe Halo. I had my preferences on Halo. I never liked the plasma pistol. I always thought the plasma pistol was bad. Okay. Okay. Spooky dog wanted a nibble. There we go. Unfortunately, as much as I like this storm shotgun, it's not the greatest. I don't know what these are. They're a little spooky. Terror level increased. Okay. That's just shred dog. Okay. And I now see a riot shield. I'm gonna wait until my shields come back. Okay, grab them. I still see that guy back there. Get this back. This boss looks like he's gonna be kind of a tough sucker. However, I can just kick him from behind it, and I think it just deleted him. Either that or it was the shotgun. I'm not fully sure yet. Those missiles are mean. Let's see. Hang out? Nope. Yeah, can you delete those walls? It looks like you've got to be able to. Oh, and that's barbed wire. Also, you no longer, or at least maybe with this weapon, you no longer just waste ammo if you reload with that a full clip. That's kind of that's a nice change of pace. Okay. I'm just gonna shred these guys. Oops. There we go. Nice. These are all traps, aren't they? Yeah, those are spikes. Mean. Okay, we got a bunch of bumpers. Got them. Okay. And that only hurts a little bit. So here's the question. Can I destroy a barrier? I got a test. Can I delete whole wall? No. Damn. Okay. That's a shame. I was really hoping I could delete an entire wall. Alright, you. You scum. There we go. Ooh. Maybe that's fine. Maybe less fine. There we go. Kick first, ask questions sometime. Grab ammo. Whoops. I don't actually know if that does damage. I hope it doesn't. Certainly appreciate taking less. Let's see. Oop. There we go. Yeah, the shotgun is incredibly good. Oh, that's my riot shield. I murdered my friend. I think that's why he wasn't trying to hunt me down and kill me. I guess that's what I get. Oh, I got tasered. I got tasered, but I also exploded. There we go. I like this shotgun, but if it can't one-shot, then it loses a lot of its immediate reason for existence, which is unfortunate. I mean, it's still good, but that reload speed is brutal. Trying to work around that is tough. Can I hit those? No, I can't. I was really hoping I could, you know, snipe slow-moving missiles out of the air. Okay. Eject. Reload. Delete. Yeah, we're doing it. My HP is looking more than fine. Alright, I don't see anything else, so I'm just gonna work on shredding that guy. You know what? Oh no, you do waste ammo. It must be a shell-fed weapon thing. Which actually makes a lot of sense. What was that? Oh, here we go. Protection fee. Increases armor. New passport. Removes negative effects. Reduces strength and negative effects. Or heist equipment. Grants a random black market item. I got a lot of money, so I'm going to go for a black market item. Unelite kills, damage boost, and extra ammo. Cool. I'll take it. Okay. Oops. This is a bit dicier than I wanted it to be. Okay, I'm gonna just hang here with my explosive weaponry. There we go. There we go. It gets hectic, but it's fine. What does the foghorn do? I don't know. I'm just gonna delete. I'm just gonna delete from afar. I can't hit turret. But I can outrange turret. There we go. I know there's like an engineer type character that you can get. Oh, I should get him. Also, looks like I've missed a number of pickups or something. Oh yeah, there it is. Yeah, let's go back. I don't actually remember if there's much of a time limitation. Oh, that item's inside. Auto taser is great. I'm sorry, Riot Shield, buddy. I feel like if I stand there, we move on to the next zone. I don't want that. I mean, maybe it's okay. Let's see. Let's just see what's out here. Because I think it can go back. I don't think there's any major limitations. Boy, this lineup is spooky. Ooh, what is this? A weapon. Akita Fusion, well-rounded full auto, good against shields. Let's see. Yeah, I'm gonna go with it. Oh, maybe we needed a key for that one. Good against shields indeed. Only immediate problem, not the most accurate. Right, shield buddy's doing his job. Did I actually get it? I think I did. Alright, then we just have these guys. Here's the thing though. Okay, so that's definitively the exit. There we go. Okay, so let's grab whatever this is. And I think I'm gonna run back. Because we've definitely left a couple of things on the ground, and there's whatever's inside that building. Now, this is pre-alpha, there's a very real possibility that I'm not gonna be able to get inside. But it's clearly not progress, therefore it's worth trying. Don't see anything in there. Okay, nothing in there. Yeah, what is this? And why is this sparkly? There might be secrets or something. I'm not entirely sure. There's very clearly like a sparkle here. Oof. But yeah, I'm not getting it. I don't know how to get in there. It's fine. And while I wasted some ammo, this guy is high efficiency ammo, so it doesn't matter either. Gosh, I love the visuals on this game. It's so clean and smooth. It feels like really high-tech toys more than like full realism. I'm sure if I was zoomed up and zoomed in, I think I'd have a different opinion. But this camera angle just very much makes it feel like, man, I'm just playing with like really destructive toys. I don't know how to describe it. It kind of reminds me of the old Sarge's Hero games. Okay, I don't know what the alarm bot is. Well, it's dead. What else do we got here? Get some ammo. Anything else here? Got another one of those. Where am I going? I don't know. Okay, turd is dead. Boy, that kick doesn't quite have the oomph that I'm looking for. What is the point of that? This? What is the point of this area? What is even here? Clearly some enemies to destroy, but that's about it. Man, what do we spend the upgrade kits on? Unless it's like an EXP thing. It could be. Okay, so we're definitively crossing the bridge here. Dunno. Hello, foe. I hope you like explosions. I brought many. Yeah, there's all of the alarm bots around. Which, like, I remember there were alarm bots in the first game, and they would summon elite units occasionally. Haven't really seen that as an option yet. Okay, do we go here? Yeah. Get dog. I don't even know what those weird bumper-looking things are. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of the Akita Fusion. Judge Revolver. Oh, hell yeah. Soft ballistic, soft point. Ah, shoot, it's gone. I thought there was a way that I could look at these things. It's fine. You would? Yes. Rubber grenade launcher, police breaching shotgun, or another Akita. Oh, but it's an Akita versus... it's fine. Okay, so I have to be very accurate with these. Is it not control? Nope. Is it escape? Weapons. Can I check? Okay. Judges. Oh, because it's randomly generated. Use ammunition with too much grain. So extra critical damage and chance, but higher recoil. Soft point and cadence. Passively increases fire rate. Oh, right. And then there's also takedown. Weak point hits briefly reduce recoil and grant increased weak point hits. When owning four more armor-piercing tech items, weak points execute targets at low health. Interesting. Upgrades. Now these are just the things that I've picked up. Class. Because I know there's like kind of upgrade looking kit things that I keep picking up. But I don't quite know what they're useful for yet. Because in the first game, you would specifically pick up an upgrade kit. You'd specifically pick up an upgrade kit, and it would make your... You'd be able to, like, upgrade one of your guns. Both statistically and also get it some perks. There we go. Credit where credit is due. This gun slaps. Get them with the crit, and they go down. Like I said... Almost every gun in this game, almost every weapon in this game is going to feel incredible until it doesn't. That's okay. I grabbed that. I don't actually even know what that is. Okay. I don't think I'm going to be able to get more than this. There he goes. It's a beautiful thing. Let me tell you. pinpoint accuracy and just absolutely beasting things. It's so good. Okay, let's just... oh boy. That's what happens. Okay. It's fine. Terror level 2. Now that usually summons a mid-boss of some variety. Yeah, there he is. I think. Could be... Nope, that's just a regular dude. Yeah, so the alarm bots will summon more enemies that I'll have to... contend with. There we go. Now, I'm not quite sure how the level system works with the weapons on this game. Because I don't think that... I don't think that was a thing in the first one. Okay, what are you? Because you are most definitely a shop of some variety. Oh, we can upgrade them. Weapon attachment. I think... Oh, okay, so I can give it an attachment. Reward system. Weak point hits gain a charge. At 10 charges, gain health. Increases movement speed and weapon cooling. I gotta go for the reward system. What about the judge revolver? Reload assist. Increases fire rate. Increases cooling. Last 5 seconds. Ammo booster. Or fire rate and movement accuracy. Reload assist. Though I think... I don't want to do the pistol. How much do I still have? Okay, wormhole mags. Ooh! Reduces deviation by 4 degrees and 20%. That's great. Increases damage range and projectile speed, or damage range, damage and recoil. Big bore... Big bore. Do we just go all in on this thing? Grants ammo regen. Triggers when shields are down. Changes the weapon to rapid fire twin burst or 10% no ammo cost. Okay, it looks like we're out of that one. So increases weapon heat, but also increases weak point damage. Reduces deviation, damage against armor. Or are these rarities? Sure. I'm just going to keep investing in this thing. Well, maybe not. SC. Extra burst amount and fire rate. Chance for crits. Increases luck by 1%. Stacks up to 100%. Oh! For every crit, it increases luck. Or... Increases negative effect status. I don't think this gun does that. Well, let's go twin burst. Alright, I think I'm out of stuff. But I'm also feeling, like, really good about my current weaponry. Okay. Okay. So if I stand for half a second, we get some perks. There we go. I don't know if these are actually going to give me the health that it's advertising or not. Should also see if these are like vending machines that I can interact with. It's a possibility. No, doesn't look like it. It's fine. I'm having a good time. I'm just trying to figure out what is the maximum cheese that I can invest, I can gain out of this. But I think we're going to have to try the revolver. Ow. Shoot, that hurt. Oh, that's mine. Again. Well, at least I'm back up to full health. Alright. Bye. Bye. Holy shit. I don't know, there's just something about it. I like sniper rifles in games. There's just something really satisfying about just popping something off. I'm bad at it. Swift Revenge activates on taking damage, returns one bullet straight to the magazine, returns laser damage. Interesting. Alright, let's just pop up here. What do we have? We have the exit, we have a shop, and we have some fools. There we go. Ooh. That hurt. I don't know if that was theirs or mine, but at least we got a health kit. Unfortunately, okay, I want to look at those, but first I want to get these. Okay, what is this? Decreases all item cooldowns. Increases healing gain and regen. Or a weapon upgrade. Increases weapon damage by 10%. I'm gonna go for the weapon upgrade. Looks like that's the only one that I get. And the others are current gun upgrades. So I think we're fine. Alright, let's keep rolling. This seems like a boss. This seems like an interesting thing. Is it just... are we fighting a Beyblade? I appreciate the cutscene. The stakes are high. This thing will cut me in half. Okay. Oh my gosh. Okay, so that's what that means. Okay, I think I hit my friend. Ow. This is terrifying. Like, how do you fight the... oh, God. How do you fight this thing? I died. Oh, was I overheating? I was probably overheating. I think that's what killed me. Unfortunately, it's kind of hard to tell if you're overheating or not sometimes. Oh, well. Data is used during gameplays and specialization leveling. Rewards, gear. It's fine. It's fine. We did fine. I'm actually pretty sure the game would have ended after I killed the boss anyway. So now I got something that I want to go after. Mission sleeve. But, okay, here we go. Class. No. You. Grenadier. Okay, so we don't have any of those currencies. I try this Spec Ops. I have no idea if it's actually that good, though. Okay, we're level 1. I think a lot of the meta progression just isn't in the game yet. Which is okay. Yeah, what else do we have? Modding. Which is interesting that they even have modding as an immediately available thing. But that's actually really cool. Not a lot of early access roguelikes start with modding. It's usually something that's added, like, you know, after a couple months, maybe a year, or like way, way further. And I really appreciate the fact that, yeah, they've got it immediately. And it's a brilliant idea, too. By allowing modding and supporting modding right from the get-go, that means you've got a lot of people that can potentially, you know, produce content for your game. And, you know, flesh it out while you're still working on the base. And, I don't know. I think that's really cool. It could have been a waste of time. Like, there's always the possibility that, yeah, nobody's going to make any mods for your game. But I've been playing Slay the Spire all day, just those modded runs. And there's just something truly beautiful about, yeah, coming back to a game that, you know, maybe hasn't had an update in a long time. But seeing that there's just a ton of new community content to just add more. Give me more things to play around with. And I'm still sticking pretty vanilla at the moment. And so, like, I can't wait to see what happens there. And I can't wait to see what happens here as well. I mean, there's anywhere from interesting items with proc effects, new guns, maybe, even full new classes. perks and abilities that you unlock along the way. The sky is the limit. I'm a little bit interested to see like how robust the modding tools are, but the fact that they're there right from the start is huge. But with all of that said, Synthetik 2 is available now on Steam in early access. I'm not sure how much content there is, but clearly I got half an hour into a run and I was going a little slow, but that's still a really good sign as far as like replayability and early access content. And I mean, if Synthetik 1 is any indication, these guys are going to be able to pull it off and make something really good. So, if you guys like this game in any way, shape, or form, leave me a like, helps more than you know. And actually, now that I think about it, go check out Synthetik 1. It's a lot of the same as this game, a little different. I think it's going to be better at the moment, but worse in the end, if only by comparison to what this is. Because this is very clearly already leaps and bounds ahead of Synthetik 1, but the first one still holds up. But with all that, if you guys want to see more, hit subscribe. And with that, thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.